Good morning, Xavier. We welcome our students, staff, and special guests. If Angelina was here, she gives her apologies. She'd say we're proud to introduce you to our first student-led assembly here at Xavier. Today, the theme for our assembly is humanity, highlighting the current events happening not only here at our school, but at an international level. We gather to celebrate the community here at Xavier and the great work that we do in Albury, academically, in our music and sporting spheres, and to share knowledge of each other's talents. We start today with an acknowledgement of country from Talon Smith and Tara Murray.
Hello and good morning. My name is Tara Murray.
And I'm Talon Smith, and we are descendants of the Yorta Yorta and Wurundjeri Nation.
This morning we acknowledge that we're on ancestral grounds of Wurundjeri and pay respect to all Wurundjeri people, their elders, those who are here with us today, and those who will lead us into the future. We also acknowledge you here today.
The Wurundjeri Nation is one of the largest language groups not only in New South Wales but in the country. Wurundjeri country is where we call home, and it's a privilege to be here with you this morning to acknowledge it.
May we all look after the lands and rivers, and in return, the lands and rivers will look after us. Thank you.
We gather together as a faith community. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, we put our trust in you as we speak our truths about humanity in our world today. Through so much pain, violence, and hatred, we hope that your love can unite us as one. We pray for the innocent people of Ukraine, whose lives have been disrupted. We pray for those young people who struggle with acceptance and self-expression. We pray for those stuck in isolation, away from their families. Bring us to light and love as we journey through 2022.
Now please join us as we pray our Xavier High School prayer. Loving God, you have called us to be collaborative, courageous, challenged, compassionate, and Christ-like as we grow in love and wisdom each day in our Xavier High School community. Help us to put learning first as we strive to be our best selves. May we know the example of our founders and be inspired by Jesus, our greatest teacher, always knowing that the truth will set you free. We this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We would now like to invite our Principal Gavin Dykes to the podium to deliver his term to address.
Thank you and good morning. And again, I want to say how wonderful the start of the term has been for all of our students. And thanks very much to all of you, particularly our Year 12 leaders, who have done a fantastic job in preparing this assembly today and linking the theme of the assembly around humanity. It's a broad topic, and when I was told by the Year 12s I had only 3 minutes to cover so much, I was up for the challenge. I want to share a couple of thoughts that play out in three dimensions of our humanity: our own lives, our school, and our wider world. Last month, at a principal's conference in Wagga, I read an article which quoted Pope Francis stating his top 10 secrets to happiness. One thing he said really stuck with me. He articulated the way in which negative connotations, emotions, are pulling us down, and the need to be more spiritual. These were some of the words that he used. Needing to talk badly about others indicates low self-esteem. That means I feel so low that instead of picking myself up, I have to cut others down, the Pope said. Letting go of negative things quickly is healthy. Instead of talking about others who frustrate us, Pope Francis advised us that it is healthy to let negative things pass quickly and quietly. To me, that is the challenge in our own everyday lives and our interactions with others. As children, teenagers, and adults, we are all faced with the daily struggle of dealing with negative thoughts or emotions. More often than not, they can be our own or that of the people that we are hanging around. Thus, the Pope is upon us as individuals, as a Catholic school community, and as a wider world as well. Unfortunately, our national leaders and international leaders do not provide us at times with some great examples. At times, those leaders want to turn the spotlight away from their own inadequate efforts by blaming others, making excuses, or denying the truth. The situation in Ukraine, where the Russian government are blaming and accusing Ukraine for problems that Russia is facing at the moment, without acknowledging their own history of wrongdoing, is an example. So how do we in Albury, New South Wales, Australia, make a difference to humanity when some of these concerns seem so unreal and far away? I believe it's by taking responsibility for the things that we can change about our inner thoughts and actions and relationships that impact other people in our inner and outer worlds. Acknowledging that at times we are not perfect, that we do make mistakes, and that we try and repair the damage that we have done. By looking for the good in our own lives, by being grateful for the things that we have in our lives, and by enabling our talents to serve and help others, I'm sure that these are the true paths to happiness and peace. Continuing on from this theme, in a moment we'll hear from our Ducks of 2021, Ian Burton. And what I really value, respect and admire about Ian and his efforts was his ability to give to others while still working hard at his studies. As a leader within Clark House and his tireless work in the Binnie's team, to just name a couple of the significant actions Ian undertook in his time here at Xavier to care for and look after others. He is currently studying medicine, a career that surely will marry his passion and care for helping people and his brilliant mind and academic ability. So now I think it's an opportune time that we welcome Ian to the microphone to give his Duck speech for 2021. Let's give him a big round of applause.
Good morning, everyone. It's an honour to be invited back here and to see some friendly faces again. Firstly, I'll preface my speech with an apology because I've never spoken slowly at an assembly, and for the sake of tradition, I probably shouldn't start now. After doing my research for this speech, I noticed two key elements of every Duck speech: cringiness and an appreciation of the mountain of support it took to get me here, both of which I'll try to hit today. This award is a reflection of the hard work of everyone around me. My family, my friends, and most importantly, my teachers. It's rarely appreciated how above and beyond teachers go for us, and both utilising them and getting to know them as people will be my biggest piece of advice for every single student today. Not only do they know all the information, or at least appear to, but they're their biggest supporters and they want you to do as well, want you to do well just as much as you do. On that note, I'd like to thank my teachers throughout all my 6 years of schooling. Specifically, however, I'd like to thank my HSC teachers. Thank you to Mrs. Lawrence for literally reteaching me how to write an essay and for knowing the right time to bribe us with lollies. Thank you to Mrs. Williams for outdoing Tim Sloan and being not the enroller presenter we deserved, but the one we much needed during COVID. Your university level biology has served me very well in the past coming weeks. Thank you to Mrs. Willis, RIP, for knowing when we needed to understand Nessa and when we needed to talk trash about them. Thank you to Mr. Cheadle for teaching me this difference that facial hair can make in the vibe of a teacher. Thank you to Mr. Ryan for being the single-handedly chillest person in the school and for eventually being able to work out any problem. And lastly, thank you to Ms. Nero, whose work speaks for itself. Thank you for the many memorable chem pracs, and in making philosophy palatable, I'm convinced you could sell wool to a sheep. Thank you more broadly to the science faculty for letting me stink out the science block during my extension science prac. It's truly admirable how stoically everyone took it without a single complaint. And a genuine special thanks to Lisa for helping me find everything in the prep room. Now on to my Clark family. Thank you to Clark 2 for being objectively the best homeroom in the school. And Thank you to my many homeroom tutors we went through during my time, including Macca, Mr. Smith, Mr. Pinson, Mrs. Miani, Mrs. Gleason, Mrs. Willis, and Mrs. Blumley, and some of the many others whose names I couldn't remember. To Mrs. Blumley, thank you for always bringing the much needed energy and in those dreary mornings, and thank you to Mrs. Muir, who abandoned us in our final years. Thank you to Mrs. Muir for being just as competitive as me, although on that note, as the fourth consecutive Clark Ducks, I think someone should probably look into that. Obviously, a massive thanks to my family as well. To Mum and Dad for the many home-cooked meals and dinner table debriefs, to my brother Joe for his study advice, and to my dog Maisie for giving me an excuse to leave the house. Apart from the thanking component of a duck speech, most of them offer some profound advice about how to navigate school. I don't have that because school is really what you make of it. It would be a lie if I pretended to know exactly what I was doing last year. School and the HSC is something that you feel out, and there's no blueprint or template you can follow except for the cliché rule to take every opportunity presented to you. For the year 11 and 12 students, no one is going to force you to learn, and the HSC is as hard as you make it. It's about determining what you want, what you believe is attainable, and what you think is worth striving for in sport, in your job, in academics, in relationships, and every other facet of your life. And to make a liar of myself, I did compile a list of hypocritical advice that I would not have followed if someone had told me during high school. For the year 7s, try not to get stressed over assignments. It's hilarious looking back at my year 7 me who thought my ability to colour a zoo map for geography would determine my future there and then. Just enjoy making friends and meeting new people. For the year 8s, you have the privilege of pretending the old stadium was really bad and that the year 7s will never know the true struggle of doing PE prac in random places. Don't forget to use that and exercise your superiority. This one goes out to my year 9s but applies all the way up to year 12s. Please wear more deodorant than you think is necessary during summer. It is definitely necessary. And that's a piece of advice I did follow. I don't know when year 10 subject selection happens, but if it hasn't happened yet, and you'll hear this too many times, pick subjects based on your interests and not just scaling. You probably won't believe that until it's too late. And for the year 11s, you are not year 12s until the previous ones have graduated. Please remember that. And for the year 12s, the HSC is not a sprint, it's a marathon. Just kidding, I had to say that because every doc speech I've ever read has said that, but really the HSC is not a race at all. It's a chance to make memories, and it's an excuse to get out of things that you don't really want to do. Considering you're halfway through the year, I don't think any academic advice that I could offer would have a significant impact. So instead I offer, take as many photos as you can. Whilst you don't want to be that person that always has their phone in their hand and doesn't live in the moment, it's nice to have something to remember, because you're going to make a lot of memories this year, and someone needs to record the cracked things that your cohort gets up to. Try to live in the moment, because soon no longer will it socially be acceptable to play handball during lunchtime, or do a lap of the school on your way to the toilet, or beg Heather for the leftover butter rolls. And in case this speech hasn't been cringy enough, I'll leave you with one final quote from Arthur Ashe. Start where you are, use what you have, do what you can. Thank you.
I'd now like to introduce the 2022 Xavier Gateway Choir in their rendition of The Scientist by Coldplay.
Thank you.
The start of the year kicked off with a bang at Xavier High School, with school photos and the swimming carnival all occurring in the same couple of weeks of the first term. Throughout the term, many of our cohorts had the opportunity to go on each excursion. In addition to this, many events such as our twilight tours of the school and fundraisers were held, bringing our students and wider community together.
We would now like to present to you an overview of highlights of Term 1 at Xavier High School. We hope you all can relish and reminisce on our first term of 2022 together by watching this video. Thank you.
No Trash Tuesdays, listen to us. Don't bring your plastics and we'll have no fuss. Bring in new foods and fruits of good. Do the right thing and save the earth.
Yes, Charlie, good man. I love it, I love it, I love it.
The kisses of the sun were sweet, I didn't put anything in my eyes. Like an exotic trip, the radio playing songs that I have never heard, I don't know what to say. I'm not another word, just la 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 la. Thank you.
acknowledge some of the extraordinary achievements of some of our students here at Xavier, who have evidently demonstrated the core values we possess in our community. We ask that you please hold your applause until the end while we celebrate these amazing achievements, and those recognised, please stay in their seats.
Logan competed in the National Championships for Hammer Throw in Sydney during March this year, winning first place. From this achievement, Logan is now representing Australia for Hammer Throw in June this year in Mackay. We wish him the best of luck.
Ava recently competed in the 2022 City to City. She ran 10 kilometres at a time of 48 minutes and placed first in the 15 girls age group. Well done, Ava.
During March this year, Lockie Carpenter was elected the Albury Youth Mayor, alongside Isaac Street, who was elected the Deputy Youth Mayor. Both boys are working closely with the Albury Council and Mayor Kylie King to organise community events for young people and deliver significant change within the council. Well done on your achievements, boys.
Earlier this year, Kajana competed at the national level for high jump. She placed third overall in her age group, jumping a massive 1.63 metres. We congratulate her on her efforts.
Douglas recently competed in the Canberra Royals, where he was awarded Best Junior Female Alpaca Breeder and Best in his colour class, leading him to win a first place broad ribbon in the second round at the Canberra Royals. He is the youngest alpaca breeder in Australia and has a bright future ahead of him.
During March last term, Eva and Bella represented Xavier in the Open Girls Double Scull Rowing. The girls' tremendous effort enabled them to take home a bronze medal in the final. Well done, girls.
Caleb was selected for and completed the Young Endeavour program sailing from Adelaide to Melbourne over a 10-day period as a part of the Australian Royal Navy. This is a unique personal development opportunity with an emphasis on building team skills, becoming an effective communicator and leader. Well done, Caleb.
At the start of the holidays, Paige travelled to Werribee to compete in the Victorian Inter-School State Equestrian Championships. She competed over 3 days across two preliminary levels, where she placed in the top 10. Congratulations, Paige, on your efforts.
On Australia Day this year, our school captain Eli was awarded Albury Young Citizen of the Year. Along with this extraordinary achievement, he is also running for Parliament for the seat of Farrer at the upcoming federal election. This is a clear demonstration of the hard work, ethic and determination Eli contributes to make our community a better place.
During September 2021, Hope competed in the National Kettlebell Championships in Hobart and won first place. This has now led her to have the opportunity to travel to Portugal on the 28th of May to compete at the World Kettlebell Championships representing Australia. We wish Hope the best of luck.
On the 20th of April, Dominic successfully passed his final interview for the Navy and was accepted, now awaiting a recruitment date to begin his career as a combat engineer. We're extremely proud of your achievements and good luck with the future.
Last term, on March the 8th, Jack, Sam and Jake all competed at the National Robotic Competition in Adelaide. During the competition, the boys gained a wildcard position, leading to their selection in the live remote world competition, which they are now video linking into Dallas, USA next week on Monday the 9th of May. We wish you the best of luck.
We would just like to say a huge congratulations to everyone. It takes courage to put yourselves out there in an attempt to achieve greatness or the joy of doing something different. All of you who have been recognised today completely deserve the recognition for this, and we are all glad that we have had the opportunity to become aware of your achievements. We would now like to call Mrs. Williams to the stage to recognise the individuals who assisted in the scribing during the Year 12 exam period. We would also like to acknowledge those who participated in the ICAS assessments in 2021. We would now like to invite them to the stage to receive their certificates.
William Thompson. Samuel Kirk. George Jerome Honey Chang. Ned Welch. Stella Biles. Now for the Shooting Awards, Molly McLaren, Alicia Spears, Amelia Street, Millie Norman, and Lucy Brennan. We'd now like to give everyone a big round of applause.
Opportunity to venture out into the yard in classrooms of the school to talk with and interview students and teachers. During this, we collected footage of the experience. We would now like to present to you our first volume of Street Talk for 2022. We hope you can all share a laugh and enjoy the video. Thank you.
Understand, but as well as that, the kids, I love the kids.
Perfect, thank you for your time.
We're here with fellow debutantes of the Lamington campus series. Colby, how's the day going?
Oh, very good, very good. Keep two snags, and that's what you want. That's my 3 points, actually.
Hello, girls.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
Mind if we give you an interview? All right, where we are. So, how's the day going?
Good.
What's your favourite subject?
Probably music.
Music?
Yeah.
What do you like about music so much?
Neville.
Mr. Neville. Mr. Neville is really cool.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good though. Nice.
What are your thoughts on the current economy?
No, I'm not having
that. That's like the only thing you know.
So what are you getting for Easter today?
Life-saving some cookies.
Oh, delicious.
From the slice.
Good choice. What are you getting for Easter today?
Caramel slice.
Oh, that's very popular. Salad roll. Oh, yummy.
The earring, what's the go for that? It's a representation of a past family member.
That's fair. That's actually nice. It's a hammer throw.
Yeah.
What's a... Anyway, it's a hammer throw. Like, you're looking at getting that, like, for real? Like, make some money out of it?
Yeah, I'm starting to make a bit of bank from it.
Ollie! Ollie!
Yeah, sure, I'll be facing. Oh, that's mad. So,
We actually had our netball gala day. Let's say 7-8 boys are through to Wagga, go team. Son wasn't out at all, but my face is skin on.
Well, you would turn up like a tomato.
Well, I have. Yeah. That's sick.
Our leaders have turned to.
It's really good.
What's it like? That's how it's like being married against the dice.
What's it like playing tennis against the dice?
Playing tennis against the dice, it's alright. It's pretty average. Not really.
You really want to say that?
The athletics carnival is coming up soon.
Athletics carnival is coming up.
Who are you dressing up as?
You'll just have to wait and see. More reasons turn up. Participation is everything.
Yeah.
And really, I think we just look around at all of our great students. Everyone's got a bit of talent that they can express.
They do.
And even if you can't run very well, or at all.
At least you can, you can crawl with.
Here we have best customer, Harry Plunkett. What's on the menu today?
We've got a real pork portello and a salad roll.
Thank you.
Mr. Willy Burger. Is it Willy Burger?
Yes.
Is that your actual name?
Yes.
That's a sick name.
Why would I be, if I was, Paul Jeffries, why would I call myself Willy Burger?
I don't know. I've never known Willy Burger. Sounds like a really good burger.
My father was a Willy Burger. My grandfather was a Willy Burger.
So there's more Willy Burgers.
There's lots of Willy Burgers. There's a whole line of Willy Burgers.
Oh, lots of Willy Burgers.
Yeah.
That's good.
Can I go now? I'll come in and go for the shit.
Yeah, you probably go.
Yeah, I think you should go to Mass.
Yeah.
Have a bit of confession.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, it's a good idea. See you, boys.
We'd now like to acknowledge the success of Matilda Walsh from Year 8, who was awarded second place for the Liquitex Sneaker Design Prize. This was a competition that brought together Ecclesiastes, one of our school's art suppliers, Liquitex, and Dunlop Valley, and asked students across Australia to create a design for Dunlop Sneaker. Matilda has won a prize, a pack of Liquitex art materials, and a Volley website store credit. Congratulations, Matilda. Lastly, a big congratulations also goes to Fletcher Brown on his winning submission for our School Street mural competition. His design will replace the current work in the space between the science labs. The theme was Create Your Future. His vibrant owl design represents bravery, wisdom, knowledge and transformation. And just like the owl, by revealing and celebrating our vibrant colours and our unique and collective strengths, we will be ready for what life and the future brings. We'll now invite Miss Boyd, as well as Fletcher, to present him with his $100 cafe voucher. Whilst Fletcher makes his way forward, this is an opportunity to acknowledge that his artistic skills have also been commissioned by the Albury City Council for various infrastructure aspects of the new skate park. We should be able to see some of his work in the images being shared with you now. A big well done to Fletcher on your continued achievements and investment in your art making.
We had a great time in Term 1, but now that it's Term 2, there's so many more exciting things that are coming up. We're starting our term off strong this Friday with Athletics Carnival. Wear your house colours and meet us down there. We can't wait to see you all giving it a go and doing your best. There's also heaps of sports trials coming up, so make sure you keep an eye out on Compass and check them out. NAPLAN is also coming up next week for Year 7 and 9, so good luck and keep an eye out on Compass for more details. The Wednesday homework and study sessions for maths are continuing this term. If you need any assistance or further support with your maths homework, come to the library on Wednesday afternoon at 3:30 to 4:30. All you need to do is fill out the permission slip from the office and keep an eye out on Compass. For more exciting events coming up this term, just keep an eye out on School of G and Compass, and we hope you enjoy the rest of it. Thank you.
To address the current global events, we would like to pay our respects to the people in Ukraine. As you may be aware, there is an ongoing war inflicted by the Russian government towards the people of Ukraine, which has resulted in the loss of thousands of Ukrainian lives, as well as many innocent civilian Russian lives. We recognize and are grateful for the support provided by surrounding countries such as Poland. Since February of 2022, over 2.5 million Ukrainian citizens have been reported looking for refuge, crossing the Polish border. This means that they have provided accommodation for over 60% of the total 4.5 million refugees. As stated by a Polish journalist, today Poland does for Ukraine what nobody did for Poland in 1939.
Margot and her husband, Polish citizens, opened up their homes and their hearts for Lila and their son Glenn from Ukraine. To the ABC, Marta spoke to the fact that they have no time frame on their stay, saying they can stay as long as they want. She helped Lila find work as they map out their new life far from their hometown. Glenn has been protected from the war, with both families helping to settle into his new life. The empathy and kindness shown through the acts of these people has modeled the behaviour of over 1 million Polish citizens who have followed in their footsteps of providing homes for refugees. This is a call to action to people all over the world, including yourself, to take this message of compassion and reflect it into your own lives. In current society, it is crucial that we acknowledge and remember the coming together of global community during dire times and think about what we can do for other people in need.
We would now like to introduce the 2022 Gateway Band in their rendition of Straight Lines by Silverchair. Take it away, guys. Thank you.
hard act to follow. Well, that brings us to the end of our inaugural student-led assembly. In reflecting on our theme of humanity today, it might take an impact on you when you're passing someone today, and think about the actions that you're having on the people around you, whether that be giving them a smile, helping a teacher with their books, or putting yourself out there in a math class willing to answer those tough questions. It's been wonderful to see the talents of our students here at Xavier shared today and demonstrating that together we can be our best selves. Thank you to our student leadership team who have been gathered in the back here. Can we give them a round of applause? A special thank you to Ms. Kilroy, Luke Preston, Nick Manning and Sam Kramer for your support behind the scenes. Thank you, Ian, who's not there anymore, for joining us and sharing some of your reflections of your time here at Xavier with us. And finally, thank you to each and every one of you. Assemblies are sometimes a little bit boring, and we've hopefully tried to liven it up a little bit today, but you've conducted yourselves with a really respectful and reverent manner, and we thank you for that. As we leave today, let's remember our unity and strength that we hold as a community, united in faith.